So we're going to continue to work with the heroes and cowards model today, and we're going to talk a little bit about how you might want to extend it, which is a topic we're going to get into in a lot more detail in the upcoming units. But one of the first things you might see once you've been playing around with the heroes and cowards is you might ask the question, well, what if not everyone is a hero or not everyone is a coward, right? And right now the model doesn't allow that. So one way we can fix that is we can edit the chooser to allow cowards, heroes, and mixed personality types, for instance, right? And so now if we go over to the code, we now have to figure out how to address what happens when the personality type is mixed. Well, the first thing I would do is I'd find all the places where I'm using personality, and the only place I'm actually using personalities, if you look at, is just this one spot in the setup, right? Because after that, I set the color, and the color represents the personality. So I can then just use this one spot to help me figure out how to set up the personalities. And you know, what do I want by a personality of mix? Well, I want some of the people to be cowards and some of them to be heroes, which essentially means some of them are red and some of them blue. And so what I can do is I can say set the color to one of, and here I'm going to create my own list, which is red and blue, right? And so this says, you know, basically set the color of this particular turtle, this particular agent, to one of either red or blue, right? And when I click back over now and I set the personality types to mixed, you'll see I get a mixed group of individuals. Some are red and some are blue. Now you might ask the question then, what's going to be the outcome of that, right? Well, if I let it run, you see that you actually get some very interesting kind of behavior where some are on the sides and some are on the, and then some of them are frozen in the middle. And in fact, this is something that really depends upon where the turtles started, where they wound up, and which exact turtles wound up red and blue. And we're going to explore that in a little more detail when we go look at the actual Heroes and Cowards model that was built for the textbook, right? But I want to look at one other thing before I stop with this extending this model, which is I want to look a little bit about thinking about how to extend it to visualize who my enemies and my friends are. Okay, so let's say you like your model, you like what it's doing, but you're not 100% positive that it's working the way you want it to work, right? So let's take the simple example of heroes where you're trying to move in between two individuals. One thing you might want to do is use the turtle inspectors to debug your model. So I'm going to inspect one of these turtles. And, you know, we kind of showed this off before, you know, now they have this property of friend and enemy. And what I can do is I can actually create some visualizations to help me explore whether or not the model is working the way I want. So I'm going to have this focal turtle, which is turtle 98, create a link with its friend. And I'm going to have it set that color of that link to be green. Right, and let me blow this up. Oh, actually, that's right. So I now have created that. Unfortunately, it's can't blow up the actual turtle window, so I can't make it any bigger for you to see. And now we're gonna have it create a link with the enemy, and I'm gonna have it make the color of that link red. Right, and so now you can see where this turtle is and kind of where, and so we know from the hero's rule that if this is his friend and this is his enemy, this turtle should move to roughly this location, right? And so what we can do is we can turn the speed down and see, does the turtle move there? Well, first of all, it does, as you can see, it turns around right away and starts to head in that direction. So that's giving me pretty good confidence that it's doing what I want, right? And now I can speed it up a little bit. And of course, it has to keep updating its own destination because the friend and the enemy are also moving under their own set of rules as well. And now it's gotten to be halfway in between. It's kind of just oscillating back and forth. And you can see that the friend and the enemy are moving back as well, right? So this is just a cool little way. I often use the inspectors to kind of debug my code, make sure it's doing what it's doing, right? And of course, we can do the same thing with the cowardly code as well, if we wanted to check that. So, yeah, so that's a great way to extend your model, kind of in a way that allows you to debug. Of course, you could have all the different turtles have friend and enemy links, but that might clutter up the display quite a bit. So if you're using it for debugging, it's usually easier to do it for just one of them. So in the next lecture, we're going to talk a little bit about some of the things that this model can teach us about documentation and random numbers.